is also not coming on, keeping with the reluctance.
In my favor.
Miss Lira Rocha. Earlier, Lira?
Lewis.
Okay. Miss Lira, tell us about your days at St. Mary's, which year to which year, and your most striking memories.
I began in...
A little bit loud. Don't know.
I began in... 69.
As a student?
No. This is a teacher. Yeah. You want me as a when I was a student, yeah? Now 69, yes, I joined in 69. 67, 68, it could be.
68 or 69, yes, wherever.
Somewhere 68, 69, yeah. And then I was a student for 3 years at St. Mary's, because at that time SSC was in the 11th standard.
Right.
So I had 9th, 10th, 11th, yeah. And of course there was the drawback because of Hindi.
Yeah.
And... then we were given an option that we could drop Hindi and do typewriting. So that was the option I had taken. And from there I went to college after St. Xavier's. As soon as I finished my BA, there was a vacancy at St. Mary's. And I knew the principal then. So she
Sister
Angelique.
Angelique. Yeah.
So she gladly invited me. She says, come on, try it out. And I was happy to be teaching. I loved to be with the children.
English and geography.
English and geography, yeah. So, and of course, there in school they give you other subjects too.
Right.
Like, you know, a PT class or some other class like that. So I was glad to be there with among the students, and I found it so good to be teaching. Yeah. Yeah. Then I had to do my B.Ed. because we were not. I had not done my B.Ed, and that time the government had allowed us, like, you know. 1 year, I mean, that we could finish our B.Ed and teach at the same time.
I see.
Yeah, so we could do both things, you know. So, mornings I would go to teach, evening I would go to the B.Ed college at Nirmala's. And in the meanwhile, I got married also, so Michelle came along. So,
I see.
You know, I had lots to do.
This is now 74, 75 where you got married,
76.
No?
76. 76, yeah. 76.
So, the English and geography teacher got married in the girls' school, got married to the English and history teacher in the boys' school. Yeah, match bound to happen.
Yes, yeah. So it was, yeah, then I mean, the career, teaching career progressed, and I was really happy that I really found my
passion,
vocation. And the students were so, you know, till now, you find it such a fruitful vocation. Because anywhere you go, they always be lying to you and saying, Miss, remember these days and remember that day.
It means a lot to them,
and
no?
It means a lot to them, and it means a lot to us too, because you get into an office and you wonder, now whom am I going to approach and what am I going to do? And you immediately have them coming and saying, don't worry, Miss, I'll help you.
I see.
Yeah, and that is, I find it so good among the students. Yeah. Till now, they communicate, they keep in touch. Yeah.
But were schools different then as now, like the attitudes of the children?
Definitely, it must be. Yeah, it must be. Of course, I mean, not in touch with schools now for the last 10 years or more.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, it must be quite different from then, yeah. But
English speaking was also a problem in the 60s and 70s, not so few in Goa.
Yeah, true.
Had taken to the language still.
Yes, yes.
Still.
The accent was, you know, not there,
yeah.
Really. And they still not read enough, I feel. So, you know, they didn't develop their vocabulary. Like, we'd constantly tell them, at least watch the news, because then you get the correct pronunciation.
Or listen to the news in those days, radio.
Listen to the news.
I see.
And,
And then y'all Africa teachers came, bringing with yourselves your own accents and your own attitudes, and
true.
Which was very different.
Yes. It was lovely. Because we had Mrs. Lydia D'Souza,
I don't know
if you know her.
Yeah.
She was with us. So.
Nairobi or
she came
Uganda?
In from Dar es Salaam.
Dar es Salaam also. Nigel's mom. Nigel's and Carol's mom.
Correct.
She was also English?
She was English. Yeah. She was English. What other subject? I forget, but English was a main subject.
In the 70s, there was a huge return of Goan expats.
Goans, yes.
After Idi Amin and after Africanization.
Yes.
And
a lot of them got sort of jobs in the schools and things like that. So we had a very good staff. Yeah. throughout we have a very supportive staff and very united, and as a result you can do much with each other.
The schools were flowering in that sense.
Yes.
I remember the scoutmasters like Edwin Saldana and Frederico
yes.
Ataide. All ex-Africa.
They were the ones who, you know, got the students to do the president's badge and
yeah.
all that. And
yeah, the first team, the first sets
yeah.
of them, and
true.
After that kind of there was a lull.
But I guess the whole environment then was quite different from what it is now. Like to take students for camps today, probably
yeah.
it's so difficult because they have, you know, things like responsibility. The teachers
yeah.
are responsible for every little thing that takes place there. So the parents are immediately, attacking them. So it's difficult, I guess. Our time, we would just take them out into the wild, you know.
Yeah. There was so much more trust and things didn't go wrong.
True.
You know, pedophilia was unheard of and
yes.
so many things.
God was with us because there were no sort of major, any major
problems. So you came back from Africa and Ivan came back from Aberdeen, Ivan's family.
Ivan was in Aberdeen, yeah, but he was there only, I think he was born here.
His family came
down from Aberdeen, yeah. I don't think he might have gone for a holiday
okay.
in Kami, yeah, just as a young boy. But his studies was all here. He did his studies here, I think.
In Britos.
In Britos. And I don't know,
Xavier's
at that time at Bastara.
Yeah.
So I know he was at Bastara, yeah.
Tell us about him and your memories of... I mean, of course, that's a huge chapter, but...
He was a man who could charm everybody. And he loved entertaining. So he would be with his guitar.
I see.
And he would get everybody around to sing. And it was like nobody could talk while they were singing. If you talked, he would tell you that you'll get a forfeit. So when we had the family gatherings, it was always music and, you know, singing. And Ivan's family is a singing family, so all of them play and sing. So,
Rocha's from Bara?
They are originally from actually
Kolwale.
Yeah. But then they were, I think his grandfather was Gorzao and Anjuna.
I see.
The ancestral homes and Anjuna. And then his father built this house in Para. So that's how we have landed in Para, yeah.
So many memories of Ivan, no? He was a real colorful
yes.
character. And everyone has an Ivan story to tell
true.
In that sense.
And then April Fool's Day is another day that everybody remembers him because he was always out to, you know,
prank everyone.
And remember the family would say, this year we are not going to get fooled, we are not going to get fooled. And invariably he would somehow find some way to fool them.
Someone mentioned this story where he kept his scapula and some slippers outside the well and threw a stone in the well.
And they thought that he had jumped in the well.
And Ewan tells a story about how he set a paper where Ewan and some
yeah.
girl from St. Mary's, whom they teased him about,
yeah.
were featured in the exam,
in
question,
the exam
paper.
Question paper.
So
he'd be up to all that mischief, yeah.
Once he calls for my calendar and he, and I was hiccuping in class, he says, get your calendar.
Mm-hmm.
And then he says, okay, get your notebook. And he writes a full remark saying that, when you get hiccups, a fright is good to stop the hiccups
mm-hmm.
and all. He writes a full remark and gives it to me by the time my hiccups are gone. So I remember that. So
he was very good with children, yeah.
With children?
He was very good with all children, yeah, even our own children. Yeah.
I see.
In fact, we miss him so much now when the grandchildren have come.
I see.
We keep telling them, you know,
I see.
How he would have doted on them and how he would...
They didn't see him at all?
Kyra and Michelle's children, so Jared, Michelle and Kyra. But now Ewan's little one and Levlin's, they haven't seen him.
I see.
They were born now.
They're
just 2 and 3 years old. Yeah. 3 years and 4 years.
And
old.
Quizzing was another huge part of his life, no?
Very much, yeah. Because he was an avid reader. You know, he would read and read, and he could remember everything. So he was like an open encyclopedia. You could ask him any question. Be science, astronomy, anything, and he would give you the answers. So to him, quizzing came very easy.
Which is what he also injected into his class by saying, by the way, boys, who knows this? Like you would.
Creating the curiosity.
Mm-hmm. In that sense. This was a typical thing of the expat Goan, no? Who had very broad visions in that sense.
Yeah.
I'm not saying it's lost, but maybe we don't have it so much in Goa itself. Or it's coming, but What would he read? A lot National Geographic and things like that?
Yes. In fact, I have piles of it. That's what good you brought that topic up, because, you know, he the encyclopedias.
Britannica.
Yeah. So we have the whole set, and I was wondering who would be able to take this set. I mean, like, I could donate it to a school.
School library, yeah, should
but
be, no?
Nobody would want it now, I think.
No, 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 they would.
So if you know of anyone,
yes.
Okay, that the National Geographic, I have a whole lot
see.
Of them, yeah. If I could just give it to any library, to any place.
It's ideal for a school, no, in that sense.
Yeah.
The other person from Para who played a big role was Almeida, who
yes,
the librarian and Britos who got us to read.
Yeah, yeah. He's still there. You know?
He's still there.
Yeah. I haven't met him for a long time.
I meet his son, Anselm.
Yes, Anselm.
Thank you so much. I know you're a person of few words, Miss Lida, and getting out the words is tough. And you know, but if we had to keep going for more long, you would have. I only hope your voice is loud enough to have recorded properly. Thanks.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot.